Water reconstitutes dehydrated food to its original texture. Freeze-dried foods include fruits, meats, and fish, which can be stored indefinitely without spoiling. Scientists study how well microorganisms live in a space environment. These studies of microorganisms are important before artificial environments for space crews on extended missions are created. After 1962 successes, even more NASA progress follows in 1963. To put 1963 in perspective, that is the year that the President's Science Advisory Committee cautions U.S. citizens on the use of pesticides. And on July 14, 1963, physicists say an elementary particle of matter is found. In 1963, NASA successfully launches 6 satellites and the last manned Mercury Earth orbital mission. NASA places 2 more weather satellites, Tyro 7 and 8, in orbit. They send almost 250,000 photos of weather information to Earth. And in 1963, NASA inserts the Syncom II communication satellite into an orbit 22,300 miles above the equator of the Earth. At that altitude, satellites orbit the world at a speed which synchronizes with the rotation of the planet's surface. So the satellite is stationary over one location on Earth. A communication satellite in a geosynchronous orbit is, in a sense, a broadcasting tower more than 22,000 miles high, which accounts for its great communications range. Scientists launched 3 scientific satellites, one of which is Explorer 18. Its long elliptical orbit allows radiation measurements in space almost to the moon in preparation for manned lunar flights. In May 1963, astronaut Gordon Cooper makes a 22-orbit flight around Earth. The spacecraft is Faith 7. The mission is normal until the second day. In the 19th orbit, the spacecraft 0.05 of a G light glows, erroneously signaling the start of re-entry. Later, scientists find the automatic stabilization and control system is not working. Cooper has to aim his spacecraft, fire retro rockets, and control re-entry manually. He fires retro rockets at the precise moment. Faith 7 splashes down within 4 4/10 miles of the carrier Kersage. NASA verifies man can operate efficiently during 1.5 days of weightlessness. With the flight of Faith 7, the Mercury program ends as a resounding success. In the meantime, work continues in preparation for 2-manned Gemini flights. Wind tunnel tests are done at the Langley Research Center with the Gemini shape. Scientists evaluate a 1/52 scale model in the hypersonic tunnel at Mach number 6.8 and 9.6. Objective? To see how stable Gemini will be during re-entry into Earth's atmosphere. Workers do stability tests in the 20-foot free-spinning tunnel with a small Gemini spacecraft model. Engineers study motions to see how well the drogue parachute will stabilize the falling capsule before the main chute opens. Work on Project Apollo continues as well. Scientists test drop a 1/4 scale model of the command module in calm water to get impact acceleration data. workers make other drop tests of the model lunar lander on powdered pumice to simulate a lunar dust surface. Tests include various flight paths and contact velocity of 15 feet per second. While scientists and engineers develop Apollo spacecraft, astronauts prepare for lunar flights. At the Manned Spacecraft Center, scientists develop a computer program to simulate Apollo spacecraft control. The computer displays simulated spacecraft motions on the pilot's instruments panel. Using hand controls, the pilot responds to slow the module's approach to the lunar surface and to hover and pick the best spot for touchdown. Workers study spacecraft control problems of Apollo rendezvous and docking in space with computer simulation. From what the pilot sees on the instrument panel, there is little difference between simulated flight and real flight. Training continues as all 16 astronauts take part in a 4-day survival course at the U.S. Caribbean Air Command's Tropical Survival School in Panama. They spend 3 days and 2 nights in the jungle, learning what they might have to do to survive in case of an emergency tropical landing. We've reviewed some of the early progress of NASA. Join us next time for Episode 4 when we cover more of 1963 and 1964 when NASA receives the first close-up pictures of the moon from a Ranger spacecraft. I'm Lynn Bondurant.
Looking good.
Roger, Columbia on a roll. Columbia, Houston, you're go at 40.
Roger, go at 40.